you know, something that I think we try to do is identify the teams that they played that play similar to us on the offensive end or defensive end. Like opponents, not necessarily always helps us. So just trying to study different teams that maybe run actions like we do or have different alignments that are similar to us to try to figure out how we can take advantage and what we have to worry about defensively. There's definitely some programs that they played that are similar to us and who we played. So of course we're watching those, but it's really trying to just study like teams and not necessarily like opponents. Well, one that we did play, and I think they are similar to us, coaching styles and personnel, is the Holy Cross. Obviously, Colgate got the best of Holy Cross twice, both really good games. So just kind of seeing they have the inside presence, they have guard play, that balance, tough players, and you know maybe not all the most athletic, but try to use some IQ pieces. And really, the interesting thing is I think we're kind of looking in the mirror at Colgate. There's a lot of similarities to what we do that I see in them. So I think it's going to be a tough matchup because I think we do match up pretty well to each other.
How was the mindset kind of switch in practice from last week? Like kind of how you got a rebirth from a season to now, it's hey, now you're in a playoff battle.
Yeah, I think the excitement of winning a big game at home in the second round against Niagara really just re-jolted this energy. They were excited about it, but then seeing they can go do it and then another opportunity to play at home. So the energy has been really good. But we really were fortunate. We had a day off, so the rest is important, especially after 40 minutes of nonstop basketball. That took a lot out of our players. And then the two-day prep, like we've been doing. So in some ways, it's very consistent, so our players understand what to expect, how we attack everything the same way, so it's that consistency that we talked a lot about all year.
Is it kind of nice that the WNIT is running through Vermont?
We're not complaining about home games. This is really exciting. I think big credit to our fans for coming out. That's part of the reason why we are getting these games, because we have a great crowd and a community that really has been our sixth person of the year. I think there was a moment there of, okay, what is this all about? Like, we're tired. Like, and then I was like, wait a second, we get to play basketball again, and we get to play with 2 fifth-years that aren't going to be on this court next year with us, and we could win, like, you know? So, and we got to play at home again, and we love playing in Patrick. So I think it was a little reminder of, like, okay, let's take a step back and see, like, what is this about? What does this mean for our program? How exciting this is. We're in an opportunity to do something that Vermont has not done. And so after we took a step back, I think our players got really excited about it. Yeah, I thought Malia stepped into a hole that we needed and kind of actually helped in the forward position, too. The matchup I thought was right, and Malia works hard, and she's somebody we're excited about in the future. And so to get some quality minutes at the end of the season, I think is important for her growth and for our future. All right. Thank you, guys.